Hello everybody, I'm Reg, and welcome to Holiday Club. This year's going to be very exciting and different, because we're going to break out. We're breaking out of church and coming straight into your home for the next 3 days. Just like last year, we're having songs, performances by the Motley Crue puppets, some jumping up and down, and some cool stories about people in the Bible who had to break out. Knock, knock. Noah. No idea who the story's about today. If your jokes are better than mine, send them in to childrensworker@krbc.org.uk.
Hello and welcome to Breakout, our brand new holiday club for 2020. I am Linda Leggett.
And I'm Steve Scarpa.
You don't sound very enthusiastic. Come on, this is exciting.
We've been in lockdown for so long.
You're not used to being out, are
you? I've not been outside for ages.
Well, this is just like all our other holiday clubs, but this time we are virtual.
Speak for yourself.
Yeah, you're I'm really here. So now we're actually on the internet doing holiday club for this year. Did you get your swag bag?
No.
Have a swag bag. Yes. Hopefully you've got a swag bag, a bit like this, with all of the resources that you need for our holiday club. And we are going to be finding out about people in the Bible who were kind of in lockdown.
Oh, really?
Yes, there were people in the Bible who were in lockdown, just like we have been. Bit different maybe, but we've been finding out all sorts of stuff. It's been really, really cool. It's been games and songs and craft and all sorts.
Oh, okay.
Do you think you're getting enthusiastic now?
Trouble is, I'm up much earlier than I normally would be, so I'm not sure I've got the energy for it. Thanks for asking all the same.
Do you know what you need?
What do I need?
You need a workout.
A workout?
A workout. Do you need a workout? Let's have a workout.
Okay. Let's try it.
Good morning. Welcome to day one of Wake Up Shake Up at our breakout holiday group. If you did PE with Joe, then this is going to be very easy. It's a minute and a half of moving your arms, moving your legs, getting your heart pumping. It's not good to just sit and look at the screen. You've got to be active. So up on your feet. And like Joe, I've got some objects on my shelves, and each day one of them is going to change. If you spot which one has changed and you let the team know, then there will be prizes. So, arms outside, sideways, shoulder height, and we're going to twist our bodies. One, and two, three, four, five, and six, seven, and eight, and nine, and 10. Now, put your arms in big circles forwards, as if you're doing butterfly in the swimming pool, but your whole body moving. And now change and go backwards, big circles. How big a circle can you draw with your hands in the air? Okay, we've done our arms, now we're going to do our legs. You're going to sprint on the spot. Get those knees higher, 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 higher. Nice and high, nice and high. Keep your knees nice and high. Up, 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 up. Now we're going to go down on hands and feet and do some bear crawling. Forwards and backwards. If you've got a big space, just keep going round and round in a circle. I haven't got a big space. You've got to be on hands and feet, remember, for a bear crawl. You mustn't go onto your knees, it's got to be hands and feet. One more forward, and one more backward. And stand up, and put little rabbit ears up, and do some little rabbit hops. They don't have to be very high. Rabbits aren't very big, but keep them regular. Left and right, left and right. That's it, little rabbit hops. Fast, 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 fast. Now some squat down, up, clap. Squat down, up, clap. Four more, three more, two more, one more, and we're going to end with silly billies. Shake those arms, move those legs, get your hips moving, turn around, all funny faces, do whatever you like, it's up to you, look at the shelves, and we'll see you tomorrow again for Wake Up Shake Up.
I can't do that every day. It's just too much. She's too fit.
By the end of this week, we will be really fit.
Well, I'm not sure.
Right, you ready to find out who our Bible character is today?
Yeah, that's
I'm
right.
Going to write their name
motivated
on now. This post-it note. Stick it gently on your forehead.
Gently.
And you have to ask me questions. And I can only say yes or no, okay? Guess who it is. Go on,
okay.
Ask the question.
Is it Clifford the Big Red Dog?
No.
No? Is it Peppa Pig?
No.
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 Is it a person?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Better
is
question.
Is it a man?
Yes.
I know who it is. It's Cristiano Ronaldo.
It's not Cristiano Ronaldo. He's not in the Bible.
Oh, is this person in the Bible?
It's in the Bible.
Okay.
A man in the Bible.
Man in the Bible. Is it Jesus?
No, it's not.
No.
Good choice.
Is it Moses?
No.
No. Is it King David?
No.
Is it Solomon?
No.
No? Am I close?
Ish.
Is it Peter?
No.
Paul?
Further away.
Ringo?
No.
No? I don't know.
Help me! Come on.
I give up. Who is it?
Noah.
No. Tell me who it is.
Noah.
Yeah, I know, but go on.
It's Noah.
Ow, okay. You took some skin then.
Sorry. Okay. That is coming up in a moment. Noah, but I think...
I can't wait to hear a story. Let's go.
No, wait. Sarah is here first with a challenge for you.
Ah, one of her challenges, eh? I've heard about these.
Oh, yes.
Hi, boys and girls. Welcome to the breakout challenge for today. What will I do? What will I say? Now, if any of you are out there this morning feeling really bored and fed up, when I was bored and fed up, when I was your age, all I got to do was this. And it's taken me a long time to get there. You guys are super clever. You can play with all your games and your smartphones and your iPads and you can use both your hands and you can shoot and fire and twist and turn. This is all I had, but it was a long, long, long time ago. But even longer back in time than that, there was a bloke called Noah, who you're going to find out about today. He never had any time to be bored. He had a job and a mission to do, and it was really important that he could use two hands at the same time to do two tasks, to get this giant big ark built. Your task today, guys, is to get a saw and a hammer, or two objects that kind of, well, can you move like a saw and a hammer can? And see if you can saw with one hand and hammer with the other. Because that's not what Noah and his team would have had to do. See if you can do it, guys, because I'm rubbish at it. Right, I'll try the other way around. So saw, hammer. No, it's no good kind of wobbling and twisting. To get a job done properly, you need to saw accurately. Otherwise, Noah's art wouldn't have got done. And you need to tap accurately as well. And I'm not sure I'm going to manage this. See how you can do, boys and girls. Catch you again. Bye.
Hello, my name's Jo. I'm going to be reading today's story. It's called A New Beginning. Time passed and many people filled the earth. Everyone everywhere had forgotten about God and were only doing bad things all the time. God's heart was filled with pain when he saw what had happened to the world he loved. Everywhere were bad things, disease and death and destruction, all the things God hates most. Now Noah was God's friend, which was odd in those days because no one else was. Noah listened to God and he talked to God. He just loved being with God, like you do with your best friend. Noah, God said, things have gone wrong. People have filled my world with hate instead of love. They are destroying themselves. They're breaking themselves and each other and my world too. I must stop them. First, we'll build an ark. Do you know how to build an ark? Mm-mm. Nor me, and neither did Noah. Luckily, God knew, and he would show him. There he is, there's Noah, and there's the plan of the ark. A storm is coming, God told Noah, but I will rescue you, I promise. I'll send the animals to you, ones that creep and crawl and slither and slime and gallop and hop and bound and climb. And don't forget to pack everyone's food. The storm was going to wash away all the hate and sadness and everything that had gone wrong and make the world clean again. God had thought up a way to keep Noah safe, but Noah would have to trust God and do exactly what God told him. So Noah built an ark, and an ark is a very, very large boat. There he is. My goodness, what a big boat. Noah's neighbours came out to watch and laugh. What's he doing, they said, because they didn't believe Noah about the boat or the storm or needing to be rescued. And Noah must have looked rather silly. His boat was in the desert, big sandy place, a long, long way from the sea. And there wasn't a cloud in the sky. Why would anyone even need an umbrella, let alone a boat? There they are, they're laughing at him. Why is he building the boat? But Noah didn't mind what other people thought. He only minded what God thought. So he just did what God told him to do. And when the ark was ready, God said, "All aboard!" And Noah's family and all the animals climbed inside. And then God shut the door. And safe inside, aren't they? And it started raining, just like God said it would. For minutes that joined up into hours, that joined up into days, that joined up into weeks and weeks of rain. And the rain turned into puddles, that turned into rivers, that turned into lakes, that turned up into a huge flood that covered the whole world. And their boat, that had once seemed very big, suddenly seemed very small. There it is. See the boat? But in the middle of the huge storm, in the crashing waves, in all the thunder and all the lightning, through it all, God was with them. And God kept them safe for 40 days and nights. That's a long time. Finally, the rain stopped and the sun came out and Noah threw open all the windows. Hooray! Everyone shouted. And Noah sent his dove to explore. There you go, little dove. Off it went. And she brought him back a fresh olive leaf in her beak. Fresh olive leaf. Everyone knew exactly what that meant. The little dove had found a tree. And land. The tree was growing on the land. The water was going down. At last, the boat landed quite suddenly on top of a great mountain. Wow, look at that. As soon as it was safe, God said, "Out you come." And so they did, everyone skipping and dancing onto dry land at last. The first thing Noah did was thank God for rescuing them, just as he promised he would. And the first thing God did was make another promise. "I won't ever destroy the world again," said God. And like a warrior who puts away his bow and his arrow at the end of a great battle, God said, "See, I have hung my bow up in the clouds." But you know what that is, don't you? Beautiful rainbow. Just where the storm meets the sun, there was the beautiful bow made of light, a rainbow. It was a new beginning in God's world. It wasn't long before everything went wrong again. But God wasn't surprised, and he knew this would happen. That's why, before the beginning of time, he had another plan, a better plan. A plan not to destroy the world, but to rescue it. A plan to one day send his own son, the rescuer. God's strong anger against hate and sadness and death would come down once more, but not on his people or his world. No, God's war bow was not pointing down at his people. It was pointing up into the heart of heaven. That's the end of today's story.
It's amazing, isn't it? Can you imagine being locked away all that time in a huge boat with all those animals?
No, and I get seasick as well.
Imagine the smell.
I bet it smelled.
Oh, dear. But even though it was really, really hard for Noah, he trusted God.
Oh, yeah, he did, didn't he?
Did,
he? Yeah.
And he knew that God was looking after him and God wasn't going to let him down.
Good point. Good point, yeah.
And in the end, it was all okay and they came out and they started their new life. And the rainbow, do you remember what the rainbow
was? Yeah, we see lots of rainbows at the moment, haven't we? Loads of them.
Brilliant. Just a sign of God's promise
that
he would never flood the earth again. That is so cool, isn't
it? That is cool, I admit that.
One of my favourite stories, all those animals. Yeah. And I think now, in a minute, we're going to have a craft. We're going to have a video. Are you any good at craft?
Not really, but I'm willing to learn.
Watch carefully.
I will watch ever so carefully.
After that, we've got a song with loads of puppets.
Loads of animals, I've heard.
Loads of animals.
Loads of animals.
Brilliant.
Brilliant. Bring it on.
Butterfly, I thank you, Lord, for giving me wings.
If I were a robin in a tree, I thank you, Lord, that I could sing.
If I were a fish in the sea, I wiggle my tail and I giggle wiggly. But I just thank you, Father, for making me me.
For you gave me a heart and you gave me a smile. Gave me Jesus and you made me a child. And I just thank you, Father, for making me me.
If I were an elephant, I'd thank you, Lord, by raising my trunk.
And if I were a kangaroo, I'd just hop right up to you.
If I were an octopus, I'd thank you, Lord, for my fine looks. But I just thank you, Father, for making me me.
For you gave me a heart and you gave me a smile. You gave me Jesus and you made me a child. And I just thank you, Father, for making me me.
If I were a wiggly worm, I thank you, Lord, that I could squirm. If I were a fuzzy wuzzy bear, I thank you, Lord, for my fuzzy wuzzy hair. But I just thank you, Father, for making me me.
For you gave me a heart and you gave me a smile. You gave me Jesus and you made me a child. And I just thank you, Father, for making me me. For you gave me a heart and you gave me a smile. You gave me Jesus and you made me a child. And I just thank you, Father, for making me me.
I am sick and tired of being locked up in this place.
I know what you mean. I mean, what I can't believe, though, is that some government official thought it'd be a really smart idea to turn abandoned churches into overflow prisons. I mean, I thought they were more sensible than that.
Well,
Does anyone still go to church these days?
I think so, but I'm not sure. Anyway, what are you in for?
Toilet roll smuggling.
Cool. What happened?
Well, I had 1,000 loo rolls in the back of my car, and unfortunately one of them ripped open and started unwinding. So as I drove home, all the police had to do was follow the trail of paper all the way to my front door. Nicked me.
You see, they were expecting to find an Andrex puppy at the end.
Yeah. What about you?
Yeah, I bumped into somebody in Asda and broke social distancing rules.
No.
So what I was at, yeah, so keep your distance, yeah. I was trying to get a tin of baked beans. It was the last one at the right at the back of the bottom shelf. And as I came back out, I bumped into this guy and it turned out he was a judge. So just threw the book at me.
Like,
it hurt.
Public health hazard and all that?
All that sort of stuff, yeah.
So long have you been here for?
112 days, 97 to go.
Have you ever thought of trying to break out?
Break out? You mean like escape?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. How would we do that?
Well, do you see that spade that has conveniently been left lying around?
You mean that spade that's conveniently left lying around next to that conveniently covered hole?
I do.
Cool. And we could conveniently dig a convenient hole and turn it into a convenient tunnel to a convenient place outside of this convenient church.
I think that would be very convenient, don't you?
I think that would be really convenient.
Boys and girls, this may take a little bit of time, so we'll probably speed it up. Let's go.
That they built the foundations out of Lego. But at least they'll last long.
It does seem a little bit strange. You know, I've been reading the Bible recently. There's a load of them along the back of the church.
Alright, okay. And what did you read in there then?
Well, I was reading about the story of Noah.
Uh-huh.
And now, if I got it right, it seems that Noah built this great big boat.
Uh-huh.
And then he captured loads of animals and imprisoned them in the boat for months and months and months. And then he ran aground on some mountain and all of the animals got out and escaped.
Yeah, that doesn't sound like the way I've been told that story before.
Well, I was thinking that if they had dug a hole in the bottom of the boat, then they could have all got out.
Yeah, well, the only issue there is the fact that the boat would sink.
Well, maybe so, but all they would have needed was a spade that was conveniently left lying around.
Which would be very convenient to dig a convenient hole.
It would.
Hello, hello, hello. What do we have here? Is that my spade you two have been borrowing?
Yes, it is. Yes, sir.
Is it? How are we going to finish this now?
Tut, tut, tut. You've made quite a mess. You will clean up this all, won't you?
Oh, yes, sir. Certainly, sir. 3 bags full, sir.
Just see that you do.
Come on, come on.
Now, did I hear you talking about Noah's Ark?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yep.
It seems like you didn't quite get all the details perfectly right in that.
Uh-huh.
You see, Noah wasn't imprisoning those animals. He was saving them. And if they dug a massive hole in the boat, they all would have been swished away.
Now you see, that sounds more familiar.
Hmm.
I don't want to hear any more talk about any breakouts from you two.
That told us.
Don't worry, boys and girls. We'll have another go tomorrow. See you then.
Wow, that was a bit interesting, wasn't it?
What a couple of goodness
convicts!
Me.
Yeah,
convicts.
A couple of convicts they were,
they
looked so ugly and so mean. There's something dodgy about them, don't you think?
I don't reckon they're going to get out at all.
I don't think they will. Not a chance. They thought they were going to dig their way out. I mean, what a pair of doofuses.
I reckon tomorrow they'll come up with another stupid plan.
I wouldn't be at all surprised.
Which will fail just as badly.
I don't rate their chances very highly. Not at all.
I'm quite looking forward to it though, because it's quite fun seeing them mess up, isn't it?
Isn't it? Yeah. It's nice to have to laugh at other people.
Yeah. Anyhow, maybe we should sing a song about God, because that actually wasn't very nice what we just said, was it?
No,
shall we sing a song about how God's love is really big? There are really good actions for this. I hope you're going to join in.
Excellent.
I hope you're going to join in at home as well.
I'll join in from over there.
Okay.
God who made the universe, the earth, the sun, the moon and stars, has a place in his heart for me. From the beginning to the end, God will always be my friend. So I can jump and shout, 'cause God loves me. God's love is big, God's love is great, God's love is fat, he is my mate. God's love surrounds me every day, and I love to sing and say, God's love is big, God's love is strong, God's love goes on and on and on. God's love surrounds me every day, and I love to sing and say, God loves me. Wait, hey! Since before the world began, God knew me and had a plan for my life and how I'm gonna be. He sent Jesus to be my friend, to show his love will never end. So I can jump and shout, 'cause God loves me. God's love is big, God's love is great, God's love is fab, he is my mate. God's love surrounds me every day, and I love to sing and say, God's love is big, God's love is strong, God's love goes on and on and on. God's love surrounds me every day, and I love to sing and say, God loves me. Well, hey! God's love is big, God's love is great, God's love is fat, he is my mate. God's love surrounds me every day, and I love to sing and say, God's love is big, God's love is strong, God's love goes on and on and on. God's love surrounds me every day, and I love to sing and say, God loves me. Wait, hey!
Holiday club this year is called Breakout, and we're looking at lots of people from the Bible who were either in lockdown or were locked up. Now, I don't know about you, but sometimes during lockdown, I have found myself a little bit worried and have found some things a little bit difficult. And so I thought it would be really good if this week we learnt a memory verse, a verse from the Bible that would encourage us and keep us going when things are a little bit difficult. So I'm going to tell you the verse, and then over the next few days, we're going to have a go at learning it all together. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Joshua chapter 1, verse 9.
Right, let's have a go at learning the first bit of that verse today. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Let's try it again. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. And tomorrow we're going to have a go at learning the next bit of the verse.
I don't think you've quite got Makaton, have you?
I've got what?
That was what she was doing, Makaton. It's a sign language for the memory verse.
Oh, okay. I was actually trying to do the actions to the song. I haven't even got...
Goodness me. I don't think 3 days is long enough, do you?
No.
Goodness me, you've got a lot of work to do. Anyhow, it's time to say goodbye now.
That was really quick.
I know, it's over already, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow. Remember what we've learned. What have we learned?
We've learned that God can be trusted. He looked after Noah.
Brilliant, and God is with us, even in lockdown. He's with us wherever we go, and he's promised always to be with us. That is brilliant.
That is very brilliant.
We got some challenges, haven't we?
We have. I wonder if you can do that challenge that Sarah picked up. It'd be great to see you photographed or even videoed, and if you could put that on the Facebook, get a grown-up to help you put it onto Facebook, then we'll all get to see it.
Can you do it?
Yeah. There you go. I'm sawing. It's like I'm drumming really badly.
I'll
practice a bit more.
Lots. Excellent. And any pictures that you do.
Good point.
Pictures.
Yeah.
Or any jokes.
Any jokes.
You could comment on the Facebook page or on the YouTube link. Send your comments. That'd be fabulous. Do you want to pray for us?
Yeah, let's pray. Let's pray. Father, thank you that you're in the business of guiding people, that you look after us, that you spoke to Noah and Noah obeyed you. And he did that because he knew he could trust you. Help us to trust you more, we pray. And thank you that you are with us, whatever we're doing and wherever we go. Amen.
Amen. Brilliant. Well, see you tomorrow, 10 o'clock.
10 o'clock, same time, same place.
Brilliant.